Hello everybody, this is the first tutorial in a series called Introduction to Compositing. Before jumping right into it, I would like to give you a brief introduction what the word compositing actually stands for. Compositing is the process of merging different elements, creating the illusion that all those elements are part of the same scene. The elements can be CG or from any other type of origin. To compose one element onto another, you have to have information about transparency of the pixels. You give those information, masking the wanted areas out. Now we get a black and white mask that gives the transparency of each pixel. White equals not transparent, black transparent. Now that you have the wanted elements isolated, you can add a background. As a compositor, your task is to combine multiple images, creating the illusion that all those elements are from the same source. Compositing goes from integrating a person shot in front of a green screen into a 3D environment, to extending a set or removing unwanted objects from the scene. Common terms used in the CG industry. The plate is the original source footage without any elements added, the raw footage. CG, or computer generated elements, are fully digitally created elements in your 3D software of choice. Render passes refer to separating objects into separate images. Common passes are diffuse, specular, reflection, ambient occlusion. These passes can be tweaked separately now and allow you to change the amount of, for example, reflections on the element without needing to re-render the CG elements. We will talk more in depth about them in further lessons. The channels allow you to store extra information about your elements. It's like a holiday picture that on the backside has written the date when it was taken. Common channels are alpha channel, contains transparency information, and the corner channels. They give the amount of green, red, blue in each pixel. Additional channels are, for example, the Z-depth channel, which gives the distance from each pixel to the camera. The next lesson we will be looking at the various types of compositing software and compare a node-based compositing system with layer-based. If you like the tutorial and you are looking forward to seeing more tutorials, I would appreciate your subscription. Goodbye, and hopefully I'll see you next time.